We have talked in our previous video about the different strength of acids and bases in solution, but we haven't discussed yet why some acids are stronger than other ones. The strength of an acid or a base is a relative term and depends on various aspects such as solvent, temperature, and molecular structure. We can investigate the influence of a solvent in the acidity strength of the three acids such as hydrochloric acid, hydrobromic acid, and hydroiodic acid by evaluating its ionization in water and acetic acid. In water, the three of them are fully ionized and hence appears to be almost equally strong in these solvents. For that reason, water is said to have a leveling effect in the strength of these acids. Regardless of how strong the acid is, the strongest acid that can exist in solution is the oxidanium, and that will be the same in the three cases. However, if dissolved now, the three acids in acetic acid, they are ionized in different extent because of the fact that the ability to accept a proton by the acetic acid is much weaker than in water. A similar reasoning could be done by the base behavior. The dependence of the acid and base strength with the temperature is more evident since all equilibrium constants vary with temperature according to the Van 't Hoff equation. An increase of temperature will lead to an increase or decrease in the value of the constant, depending on the value of enthalpy and entropy of the process. For example, if we examine the dissociation of water and we consider that the variation of enthalpy and entropy are independent of temperature as a good approximation, we observe that the value of the constant increases with increasing the temperature. In other words, pH of pure water decreases with temperature. The last aspect to consider is the dependence of acid and base strength with the molecular structure. This is a key factor when we compare the strength of two compounds at the same temperature and in the same solvents. With respect to an acid, we will be able to estimate its strength if we can deduce its tendency to dissociate a proton. In order to estimate the extension of that process, we need to consider two parameters. The first one is the bond enthalpy. The weaker the bond, the higher the dissociation of the acid. The second one is the polarity of the bond. The more polarized the bond, the easier the dissociation. According to that, if we want to estimate the acid strength of hydroalic acid, hydroiodic acid will be the strongest acid according to this factor due to the fact that this bond is longer than the rest. But if we take into account the polarity of the bond, hydrofluoric acid will be the more acidic. So what factor is the driving force to determine the acidity of a compound? Well, in the case of hydroalic acid, it is the bond enthalpy. However, what does it happen when we compare the tendency in a period instead of a group? For example, if we compare methane, ammonia, water, and hydrofluoric acid, it is the polarity of the bond which determines the higher acidity of the species. So in this case, hydrofluoric acid will be the strongest acid. What would it happen in the case of other acids? If we examine the strength of the oxoacid, we have to examine the oxygen-hydrogen bond, which is bonded to the central atom of the oxoacid. For these compounds, again, there are two characteristics that affect the strength of the acid: the electronegativity and the oxidation number of the central atom. If we compare two oxoacids with different central atoms but with the same oxidation number, we can conclude that the more electronegative the central atom, the more electron density withdrawn from the oxygen atom and the more polar the oxygen-hydrogen bond. As a result, the chlorate anion is more stable than the bromide anion, which makes more unlikely to the former taking a proton from the surrounding solution if compared with the latest. And therefore, we can conclude that the chloric acid is stronger. In addition, if we compare two oxoacids with the same central atom and different oxidation number, we can deduce that the higher the oxidation number, the more polar of oxygen-hydrogen bond, and therefore the more acidic. Another way of viewing this concept is to consider the stability of the anion after the proton is lost. A greater delocalization of the charge will conduct to a greater stability of the anions once the proton is removed. The delocalization increases when the number of oxygen is higher, so we reach the same conclusion. Similar arguments can be used in the case of organic acid. Considering both the polarity of the oxygen-hydrogen bond and the stability of the anion generated in order to predict the acid strength. For example, if we compare acetic and chloroacetic acid, the presence of an electronegative atom such as chlorine will withdraw the electron density in greater extent, and therefore the chloroacetic acid will be more acidic. If we compare acetic acid and benzoic acid, the higher tendency to delocalize the charge throughout the benzene ring makes the corresponding anion more stable and therefore the acid stronger. When we want to estimate the different base strength according to the different structure, this magnitude is related with the ability of a lone pair from the base to form a new bond. If we examine the basic nature of anions in the same group, this parameter will decrease with the increase of the central atom size due to the decrease in the ability to donate the lone pair, as a result of the more diffuse orbitals. For that reason, oxide anions is a stronger base than sulfide anions. Other important trend is when we examine the basicity of the different hydroxides of group 1 and 2 elements. The basic properties of an hydroxide increase with the increase in the electropositive character of the central atom. Accordingly, cesium hydroxide will be more basic than rubidium hydroxide, this than potassium hydroxide, and this one than sodium hydroxide. The strength of a base can also be considered in terms of their charges, so the greater the charges, the greater the basicity. For example, nitride anion will be more basic than the imide group, and this one more basic than amide group. Another argument to estimate the strength of a base is to examine the strength of the conjugate acid. So, the stronger the acid, the weaker the conjugate base. Therefore, sulfide is a stronger base than hydrogen sulfide due to the fact that sulfurous acid, the conjugate acid of hydrogen sulfide, is stronger than hydrogen sulfide, the conjugate acid of sulfate. The base strength can be influenced by the presence of electronegative elements in the base. For example, if we compare ammonia with bromazane, the presence of an electronegative atom such as bromine will conduct to a lone pair less available to form a new bond, and therefore a less basic compound. Finally, the possibility to redistribute the electron pair along the structure affects the base strength. For example, if we compare aromatic and cyclic amines, we observe that for the former, there exists the possibility of distributing the charge through the benzene ring with the contribution of the different resonance structures. So, the lone pair is less available than in the case of cycloamines, which make aromatic amines less basic.